afternoon from Emperor Energy is Carl Dumbrell and Phil McNamara. Carl, Phil, good afternoon.
Hey, Andrew.
Good afternoon, Andrew. How are you?
Yeah, very good, Phil. Thank you. Speaking to you both this afternoon from Brisbane, tell us a bit about the conference you've been attending.
Well, it's actually the APEA conference, the Australian Petroleum Producers Explorers Association conference. And on the afternoon before the conference starts, the PESA deal day is on. So we did a presentation yesterday at the deal day about Amper Energy, about our asset in Bass Strait, and where we're up to in terms of the technical assessment of the asset and the exploration potential, the development potential for a gas production facility. And we've recently finished acquiring the 3D seismic that was shot by CGG. That's added a great deal of detail to the asset and taken us a long way forward in de-risking the exploration and appraisal risk of the Judith 2 well that we're planning. The seismic is so detailed and so good that it's also allowed us to upgrade our resource. We've increased our prospective resource by another 600 BCF as a result of that information. And that resource sits above the earlier resource that was released in 2019, which is 1.2 TCF. So the 600 BCF is in the Kipper and the Golden Beach formations, which are the producing formations in ExxonMobil's nearby Kipper well. So that's very exciting for us. We think that really moves us forward in terms of what the exploration potential here is in the proposed Judith 2 appraisal well.
And what is the what are the objectives of the Judith 2 appraisal well?
The first objective is to add another suite of resource to our existing 2C resource that sits around the Judith 1 well. That's a contingent resource of 150 BCF, and we expect that the Judith 2 appraisal well could add another 330 BCF of contingent resource. Combined with the existing 150 BCF, that would get us to the minimum economic threshold, minimum economic size for a production field. So that's the first objective. Secondly, we want to test the producibility of the formations out of the Judith 2 well. We also want to test the exciting prospect of the long-time gas sands, which sit underneath the Judith 1 well and were not penetrated. Have not been explored or not been drilled at the Judith structure. So we're 15 kilometres to the east of the producing long, or what was the producing long Tom field, and we see that as a great potential upside. And in addition to that, we also want to test the Kipper and Golden Beach formations, which sit above the Judith gas sands. So there's a series of targets in the one well.
And where are you as far as permitting and planning for the well?
Permitting process to get approval for the well from NOPSEMA is currently underway. We've contracted International Well Management Company, AGR, to commence the preparation of the environmental approval or the environmental application for approval to drill the well. AGR have commenced that. They're subcontracting some of that work out to professional companies that do this work, and we expect to be putting an application into NOPSEMA in September, looking to get approval for the well by the end of 2022 or very early 2023. Our objective is to drill the Judith 2 appraisal well by August 23. The overall project objective is to have production coming out of the Judith gas field in 2027. 2027 fits right in with where we see where AEMO are projecting a real shortfall of gas occurring in southeastern Australia.
What's the expected production profile from the well?
We've done some detailed static and dynamic modelling, and obviously the Judith 2 appraisal well, one of the key objectives will be to verify that modelling. But our model works on the basis that four production wells will deliver us 80 million standard cubic feet of gas per day into a plant that would be established by APA adjacent to the existing Orbis gas plant. Okay. If I put that in terms of like how much energy is that, if you take one of the big generator sets at Liddell Power Station, Bayswater Power Station, or you go down to your lawn or somewhere like that, those generators in those power stations are typically 550, 600 megawatts. 80 million feet of gas per day is enough energy to drive a 500 megawatt generator continuously.
How much need is there for additional gas supply?
There's a lot more than 80 million feet per day shortfall forecast in 2027. The Judith Gas Field, the Judith Prospect, Judith structure, it's a big structure. When we report resources, we only report what's inside the permit that's owned by Amper Energy. So our prospective resource at 1.8 TCF, trillion cubic feet recoverable, is about 60% of what is potentially recoverable from the entire structure.
So importantly, what was the response to your presentation yesterday?
Yeah, it was good. We've had quite a bit of feedback from various oil and gas companies, from some majors, some mid-tier companies, commenting that it was a good presentation. A lot of, we've been doing a lot of marketing, but over the last 2 years, it's been difficult to get out and about and meet people. And a conference like this allows you to go and meet a lot of people very, very quickly.
Yeah, and Andrew, today's like the first time we've met with the AGR boys in person. So what this has enabled us to do is the parties that we're engaging right now to undertake all that work Phil's described, is sit down with them and say, well, what we need is ongoing reporting. So we'll be talking to you hopefully in the coming weeks with some updates of their progress and keep that moving along. So it's a great opportunity for us to be here and to catch up with the industry, something we haven't been able to do in 2.5 years. Phil spoke really well yesterday, very engaging with a very technical audience. So they're the people we've got to get in front of because they're the ones who get the project. And the bankers are here. So everyone that we tried to catch up with, Zoom and Teams and that, this is the first time in a couple of years that we've really been able to sit down and say, well, look, we've gone a long way in that time with the project.
Carl and Phil, good to see you this afternoon. Thanks very much.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks, Andrew. Cheers.